So you know a lot of cartoonists make mini comics.
Yeah.
And I've made a couple myself.
Yes.
And today I'm going to show you how to make an 8-page mini comic out of one single sheet of paper.
Oh, good.
This is easy, cheap, and useful.
Oh, yeah.
So let's go. Mini comics are great if you have a gag or a short story you want to tell,
yeah.
or any little collection of ideas.
And they're great to hand out at cons.
Of course.
Or if you need some inexpensive merch.
Yeah, and actually the first time I saw one of these at a con, I loved the idea of it, but I wasn't exactly sure how you fold it, where the cut is made. So I bought a few and I reverse engineered it.
Nice.
So I'm going to tell you how to do this so you can try it.
Thank you.
All right, first things first, let's set up the grid.
Okay.
Grab a single sheet of 8.5 by 11 paper.
All right.
Fold it in half, top to bottom. Then in half again, left to right. Then fold it one more time, top to bottom. Now that'll set up your 8 panels or pages on which you're going to put your artwork.
Okay.
Now, but this is, like, you could lay out your comic on this folded sheet of paper.
Mm-hmm.
But since you'll be making copies of this, you probably want to draw your final art on paper that isn't folded.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Right. So the important part of all this is to get your basic grid. And let me just throw some color onto this.
Ooh.
Okay, so this is vital. Mm-hmm. Once you have the paper divided into the 8-part grid, you have to know where to start.
Uh-huh.
Like which panel is which page, so that the art will flow sequentially once it's all folded up.
Oh, yeah.
Bottom right is where you want to start.
Okay.
This can be page one, but it's also likely the cover.
Oh.
And the next page in your story, though it might seem counterintuitive, is upside down above page one.
Okay.
That's page two. Then you take your story or your gag or whatever around the paper counterclockwise.
Okay.
Until you get to the panel right before the first one you drew. And that is either the final page of the story or the back cover.
Also a great place to put your contact info or social media info if you're selling these at cons.
Great idea. Now you can see this in one of my mini comics. I set up a couple of 2-page spreads.
Oh, yeah.
You can do 2-page spreads or single pages, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're going to do a spread, you need to know where those occur on this grid.
Oh, right.
The 2-page spreads land on panels 2-3, 4-5, and 6-7.
Okay. This seems like an inexpensive, easy way to tell a story or a joke or whatever.
Yeah, all you really need is a piece of paper and a pencil or a pen, and I guess a pair of scissors.
Yeah.
And you're ready to go.
Right.
You could also do this in a graphics program if you have access or if you prefer.
Right.
But after that, access to a copy machine or printer is key.
If you're making multiple copies.
If you're making multiple copies. And then you take your stack of copies and you start folding and cutting and you're ready to go.
Yeah. And if you're only making one copy, if you're just making one for your friend or make a kid making a comic for your mom and dad.
Right. You can fold it first and you can draw directly on the folded paper like I'm doing here.
Yeah.
But no matter how you set this up, no matter how you do it, there's two rules that you have to stick to.
Okay.
One, just keep sight of which page you're putting down on which panel.
Oh, okay.
So that it all flows properly.
Mm.
That's what the grid's for. And two, know your limitations. Okay. Remember, there's only 8 pages.
Yeah.
Don't go crazy.
Okay.
So for demonstration purposes only, I came up with a very quick, very simple story to use as an example for this video.
Okay.
I just came up with a title, and I kept rhyming until I ran out of paper. Now, I did mine in Clip Studio Paint.
Okay.
I set up my grid. I laid down the roughs. Then I did the pencils. And I digitally inked it.
Okay.
Then I lettered it. And I did this all in Clip Studio Paint and then printed it out and folded it.
Nice.
And this is what it looks like all printed out.
Ah.
You should be able to read one half of the story at this orientation.
Okay.
And the other half of the story is flipped.
Mm.
But to make it a mini comic, you gotta fold it and cut it.
Right.
So we're gonna fold it in half 3 times, half, then half, then half once more, just like we covered at the beginning of the video.
Right.
And if you get it all set up right, if you did everything right up to this point, the art should fall neatly within the folded grid.
Okay.
But to get 8 individual pages out of this, we still have to cut it.
Oh, right.
We're gonna cut it along the middle fold that separates pages 3 and 4 from pages 7 and 8.
Okay.
If you're a stickler for neatness and you're old enough to use a knife, you could grab a ruler and a knife and just slice it.
Okay.
But there is a much easier way, probably safer too, and safer for me because I'm always hurting myself.
You are.
You just fold the paper across the middle.
Okay.
And then get a handy pair of scissors and snip right up the middle fold there.
Ah, okay.
And then it's ready for the final construction.
Yeah, that's easy.
Yeah. So how that works is you fold the paper back along the long center fold.
Okay.
And you kind of pinch out the two sides.
Oh.
Because those are going to be your middle pages.
All right.
And, you know, you might want to go back and recrease the folds so that they lay flat.
Yes.
But basically, that's it. Like, there you go, your very own mini comic.
Oh, nice.
I mean, you have to print, fold, and cut the other 50 copies you made.
Right.
You know, but basically, it's a fun, easy way to have a little story or a joke.
Yes.
It takes one sheet of paper.
Oh, that's great.
I love this.
Me too.
All right, let's see how this thing reads.
All right. Paul McCall is way too tall.
Sorry.
By Vince Dorse. His height's not right for basketball.
Dang it, Paul!
Sorry.
In cinemas, he's a one-man wall.
Come on!
Sorry.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Sorry.
He gets no privacy in a restroom stall.
Eep, it's King Kong!
Sorry!
Despite jibes of Giant and Neanderthal, he manages to rise above it all. To feel perfectly, wonderfully small.
That was like an episode of Reading Rainbow.
Right?
That was fun.
It was fun.
So was making the mini comic, too. I know this is just a how-to.
Yeah.
But now I kind of feel like making more mini comics.
Oh, you should.
You should.
Okay.
Now you know how to do it.
I do.